Rip it up. What's up, people? Welcome back to Crash Flow. And today we got a sick rip tip. One of my favorite tricks, because it's barely a trick, and I think it's something that's really essential in skateboarding as you get better. And it has to do with more board control. But I want to talk about power slides, because I think power slides are overlooked. Like in the beginning, they might not look that cool, or kids might not be that into them, but power slides give you so much more board control. And we all know there's a million ways to stop on a skateboard, but power slides, first of all, it's like the coolest way to stop, especially like a backside power slide to stop. But if you get good power slides and you're able to stop, you just gain that much more board control. And for me, it's one of my favorite ways to stop, to slow down, and it gets you better at bombing hills. And that's bombing hills, and speed is everything with control. So I always like to focus on board control and, you know, balance. And, you know, in my experience, the faster you're doing your tricks, the better they're going to look. And power slides is just a great way to guide you through getting more speed in skateboarding. So here we go. Started, if you've never power slide, you might just want to start very light footed. And when I say light footed, I always talk about this distribution of weight, and that is you go from one foot to the other. So when you start power slides, you want to just give yourself a little light jump. And sometimes you could just do these little jump power slides. So if you stand on your board, you really want to get those back wheels to slide, and you almost want to jump off like you're gonna do an ollie. And that's what I mean by light foot. You kind of give it a little, and while you do this, it's almost like a jump on the board. You can scooch the back foot, so it looks like this. So give it a couple little scooches, and that's how you start being able to understand the balance. So the balance of a power slide has a lot to do with, as you push out, you want to just put the weight distribution under your front leg, and you push it out with your back foot. So the weight comes here, and you push it out with the back foot. So as I'm about to power slide, I would put the weight here, push out with the back foot. And then, you know, when you practice those little bumps, you just kind of do little jumps and use it. So if I do a little jump, how you like get to turning and little power slides going. You just gotta do little, you see? You can kind of go around in circles. That'll start getting your momentum going as you learn to power slide.
So here's what those little bumps power slides will look like from this angle. You really just wanna try to stay light footed and scooch the back, either direction, whether you wanna go backside or front side.
So as you step off and put your back foot towards the tail, you do a light little jump and scooch back and push out. So here's front side, boom. And once you start getting these little scooches going, the faster you go, the more you start pushing it out like a real power slide. So when you work on these little power slides, these little scooches, you just lightly jump and scooch. Lightly jump, boom, push the back foot towards the direction you want to do them. And like I said, you go backside or front side. Here's a front side, boom. So you're lightly jumping and keeping more weight on the front foot to guide it, but pushing your back foot out like a power slide. But these are just little ones. And this is what it looks like a little faster. And then as you get more speed, you start really just pushing out faster and faster, little power slides, till it starts feeling more and more like a real power slide. Also, you can hear the faster you go, the cooler it sounds. No better sound than a power slide in skateboarding.
So once you get comfortable with the small ones, you really want to extend your back leg all the way out, pushing it to 90 degrees, while keeping a lot of weight on that front leg. So while keeping most of your weight on your front leg, thrusting your whole body out, pushing your back foot into it, and then guiding it back with your back foot as well. And if you're having trouble getting the board to go 90 degrees, always remember to turn your upper torso in the direction you want to power slide. So it's hard to see, but like I say, it's a real weight distribution. And I start with all the weight on my front knee, and at the last second, push the weight out onto my back foot and kind of back onto my front knee again. Remember to really twist your upper torso and thrust your whole body 90 into it, and then shift it back. Then when you get comfortable, you can learn to power slide till you stop.
And when you power slide to stop, it's a completely different thing. You actually just try to balance as you're staying 90 and you're power sliding. So you don't want to shift your weight back to the regular way you're riding. You really just stay still. It's pretty simple. So it can be tricky though, because a lot of times when you try to learn how to power slide to stop, you might fall on your butt. A lot of times you'll just, you know, slide right out, or you might just stop and run it off. But it takes a little while, but that's one of the funnest ways to stop. It's the coolest way to stop in my book, I think. You know, if you're just cruising down the street, you go, you just stop. It's the funnest way to learn how to stop.
So after you get comfortable with front side, you might want to start trying backside power slides. But I have to tell you, they're a whole lot harder than front side. Backside power slides took me years to get, but it's basically the same technique except turning your body the other direction.
So there you go for power slides. That's about it. That's the basics of how to do a power slide. But before you get, sorry, there's bugs everywhere. Before you get all psyched on tricks and kick flips and hard flips and 360 flips, power slides are some of the most essential parts of skating. Because like I said, you can slow down, you can stop, it's a cooler way to stop. And the main part I love about it is it just increases board control. And as you get better, board control is key. So I hope you practice your power slides. Start with front side. It's usually a lot easier to learn, but start with the little bumps and then backside. Backside takes time. It took me years to get backside. So take your time, stay committed, and go for it. Later.